Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s first State of the Nation address lasted for over an hour. One analyst asserts Marcos gave a very detailed speech that contained a sound program of government, something that he notes the president did not present during the campaign period.
Of course, none of these programs are new. Some are borrowed from previous administrations. Some are even borrowed from other presidential candidates. But, you know, the fact that he is acknowledging these programs and he intends to do something about it is actually, you know, he has 6 years. If only he can accomplish half of what he has laid out for his administration, then it would hopefully benefit the country.
Management Association of the Philippines President Rogelio Singson also welcoming Marcos's speech.
What the president mentioned in his first sauna is that this already gives a clear direction to the cabinet members. This will require a lot of details, but at least clearly the direction has been given to the various departments.
Singson particularly likes Marcos's push for public-private partnerships.
I'm very happy about that statement, that he will encourage PPP, he will encourage foreign investments in the area of energy. He did mention that, natural resources development and so on.
Some cabinet members also lauded Marcos's pronouncements.
Hindi man nasabi ng ating Pangulo sa SONA ang universal healthcare, pero nasabi niya yung mga important components katulad ng healthcare workers, katulad po ng CDC bill.
But what struck some speech watchers the most is what the president did not mention in his address. Bayan Secretary General Renato Reyes believes Marcos fell short of spelling out how growth targets and government projects will actually benefit the poor. Reyes also called it disturbing that the president left out the issues of human rights, peace, and corruption. ACT Teachers Party List Representative Franz Castro, meanwhile, is disappointed Marcos did not mention what she described as the much-delayed salary hike for teachers.
Rhetorics. Yung SONA, dismayado ang sektor ng edukasyon dahil yung aming expectations kaugnay halimbawa doon sa sweldo ay hindi nabanggit. Doon sa safe reopening of classes, wala naman siyang binabanggit na paano ba magkakaroon ng safe reopening of classes.
Fisher Folk Group Pamalakaya says it is dismayed that the issue of maritime sovereignty was mentioned only briefly and without comprehensive plan. But agriculture group SINAG welcomes the president's statements on the industry. It says condoning loans of small farmers and instituting financial assistance are positive developments for the sector.